Alright, welcome back to the channel. This is going to be a super important video for all Windows users. It's also going to have somewhat importance for Linux users because this affects people using Linux as well. I'm going to drop a link to the Microsoft article I'm going to reference, as well as this article here from Bleepy Computer. I'm going to walk you guys through some important stuff that you need to be aware of with updates that are coming to SecureBoot. Just to give you a little bit of backstory as to what's going on here, this came as a result of some Eufy malware that got released recently. And also, just so you know, the video that's coming out this Friday is going to cover how to detect if this Eufy malware is installed on your system, as well as how to mitigate it. This video is going to basically be like part one of a part two video. But this is going to go over what's going on with the SecureBoot update and why it's so important. So the reason that all this got started, like I said, it's because of Eufy malware. In particular, there's a string called BlackLotus. Now, it got released about a week ago prior to me getting this video filmed, and it's been out in the public now. At first, it started out as you could only buy it. I think it ranged from like $300 to like $5,000 off of a malware forum. And it just got released to the public, so now every script kiddie and goofball that wants to try and create some piece of malware using this stuff is going to be doing it. It's a super, super advanced piece of malware. So we're probably going to see a lot of permutations of this stuff coming out here in the near future, and people's computers are going to be getting infected. So this update to SecureBoot is going to help secure that. And then, like I said, with video coming out on Friday, I'm going to walk you through doing the forensics on trying to find out if your computer is infected. Now, some really important stuff to talk about with this boot manager. Another thing that I'm gonna mention real quick, if you're running BitLocker, this is super important. SecureBoot, the TPM, and BitLocker all kind of function in a way together. Like SecureBoot, if there's a change to SecureBoot, then or if there's a change to like Windows or SecureBoot, then it could trigger like a defense system, so to speak, where it's going to throw BitLocker into recovery mode. So if you use BitLocker, before you do what I'm going to talk about in this video, make sure you have your recovery keys ready. You could either disable it if you want to. I would just recommend having your recovery keys ready just in case it triggers recovery mode, because if you don't have your recovery keys ready and some sort of an issue comes up when you're applying this patch, you will not be able to get your data back ever. It will be gone permanently. So make sure you've got your recovery keys ready if you're using BitLocker. So this summary talks about the reason that this is being done is because of the BlackLotus Eufy malware. This stuff is pretty nasty. Just to kind of give you a little bit of a rundown on it real quick, I'll cover it more in depth on Friday when we go through the forensics and mitigation of this stuff. Basically what it does is it installs at the kernel level. So at ring zero, it installs on your EFI drive. And it basically overrides BitLocker, it overrides hypervisor enforced code integrity, it overrides Windows Defender, runs in the background. It's pretty nasty stuff. Like I said, this is a very advanced piece of malware. So here's one of the big things that you need to understand besides having your recovery key ready if you're using BitLocker. The other thing you need to be aware of, Like I said, it does affect Linux, like Microsoft mentions here in the article. It's affected by Linux. They're working on working with the major Linux distros to get a fix available for those operating systems. So if you're a Linux user, just keep your eyes open because there should be some sort of an update coming within the next. With Linux, it'll probably be within the next 6 months. We'll get into that here a little more in just a minute. So it's kind of a big deal because if you read here, avoiding issues with your bootable media, it talks about how once you apply this patch, you cannot use any old media that was made prior to this. So if you're going to apply this patch, what you need to do is get your USB drive or whatever it is that you use, plug it in your computer, run the Windows Media Creation Tool, get the latest Windows up, the latest install of Windows on there first to use that as your recovery media, because anything that is older cannot be used anymore. That even includes your retail disk coming straight from the Microsoft box. That's how severe this stuff is. And that's why Microsoft is trying to get the word out, because for in order for Microsoft to go and do something of this level, that gives you an idea of how severe this threat is. And especially now that it's been released to the wild as of last week. Now, it goes over, there's two parts to this. So it goes over the install part. And I noticed before, they mentioned down here a little bit later, there are deployment phases. I did notice the update at first seemed to be optional. I've checked a couple of my Windows computers recently and I've noticed it's no longer showing up. It sounds like, at least from what I can tell, that Windows is already pushing the update out. They just haven't pushed the revocations. So we'll go ahead and cover that real quick. So like I said, make sure you get your bootable media taken care of. So you could go and look in Windows Update and look for this update here and see if it's already been applied. If it has, then you're good to go on the first part of it. It mentions again, second part, make sure your bootable media is ready. Now this is the important part. It talks about applying the revocation. Now there was the NSA released a article, a publication, PDF, whatever, talking about in it. The problem is that this stuff was made for like enterprise users that have an IT security team. And there's, you know, people with years of experience that can do this. If you're just a home user, number one, your system might not even let you do this, but they were talking about, oh, well, you could just go revoke the 2011 certificate manually and all this other stuff. The way that it's going to work for just a home user, if you want to go ahead and do this now, it's going to be forced by Microsoft here later on in the future. If you want to do this right now, they've got the instructions right here. After installing the Windows updates released on or after July 11, 2023, open a command prompt and run this line of code right here. And then you've got to restart your device a couple of times, and then you can verify that it was installed properly. Something else that's important about this. So they mention here that the first quarter of 2024, they're going to automatically start doing this. So like I said, get ready with this ahead of time because this affects all Windows users, even if you're a home user. Something else to mention with this, I'll drop a link to this article down below so you can go read this as well. This covers some different stuff here. One thing that is important, once the mitigation for this issue is enabled on a device, meaning the revocations have been applied, it cannot be reverted if you continue to use SecureBoot on that device. So basically, and I'm just gonna cover this real quick, if you're not familiar with SecureBoot, if you are, you could probably just go ahead and click off this video if you're not familiar with SecureBoot. This is an option that is enabled within your BIOS. And like I said, this has a lot of good security features to it. Like I said, if there's some sort of tampering done with the kernel of Windows, if someone goes in and starts messing around with those files, malware gets in there, this is supposed to trip. SecureBoot is supposed to be able to prevent that. Like I said, this issue stemmed from a certificate of theirs. I'll go into more detail on that on Friday's video. And some people might say, well, how is it able to go and change the BIOS, you know, go in and revoke the certificate and make changes to the BIOS itself? Well, that's really because, you know, you have the option, like you could download a piece of software from your motherboard manufacturer, run it through Windows and update your BIOS that way. It's kind of the same principle. So Microsoft can go in there and revoke that. What this is going to do is revoke that certificate. So that's gonna cover everything in this video. If you have any questions, drop them down below, let me know. Like I said, the forensics and the mitigation video is going to, well, this is part for mitigation, but that's going to be coming out on Friday, so go ahead and keep an eye out for that. But if you have any questions in the meantime, just drop them below, let me know, and I will see you on Friday.